lifetime NFL fantasy. Play flag football with the pros. Go to the Pro Bowl in Hawaii. Be in a Super Bowl halftime show. Or roam the sidelines before a real game. Visa, it's everywhere NFL fans want to be.
ESPN's presentation of primetime college football is brought to you by Park Avenue by Buick. Luxury, pure and simple. And by Visa, it's everywhere you want to be. Good night shot across the water at the Tennessee River, just outside the jam-packed stadium, Neyland Stadium. Just over 106,000, I think, is what we're going to have here tonight, give or take. And Leverton stands by to kick it off. His team back on top by 7, 14-7. Edwards and Wamsley, the two deep backs for Georgia. And Wamsley is going to return it from 4 yards deep. And all that work, and if he had gone down to one knee, he'd be about a half yard farther. Well, coming up next Saturday on ESPN, College Game Day at 11 Eastern. Then Indiana heads into Camp Randall to face off against Ron Dane and Wisconsin. At 6 o'clock, we'll be in the Big East. Syracuse taking on 5th-ranked Virginia Tech. And at 9 o'clock from the SEC, it'll be Florida and Auburn. By the way, as Georgia goes on offense, Mike, that 90-yard drive they had to score, that's their longest of the season. Carter sets up well, and it hit him right in the chest. Edwards turned around and got turned around, and White lost it.
Good coverage, though, by Fred White, number two. And, Ron, we talked about in the open, quarterbacks are going to be judged on how they do against the main opponents. Tennessee, they lost last year. Florida lost 38-7. Georgia Tech, the rivalry, right down the road, 21-19. It's unfair, but because it's a team game. But when you're the quarterback, you've got to beat the teams that no one else beats.
The other number to add to that, Mike, is no touchdowns and 4 interceptions in those 3 ball games as well. Got him open. Throws it complete, and McMichael almost turned to flip. Here is a player that the Georgia coaches really, really like. Deion Grant making the tackle. They say this kid wants to be a wide receiver, but he's 6'3", 223. That's impossible, but he catches the ball well and runs well after the reception.
Great hands, and they have 2 tight ends in Johnson and McMichael, and they're like wide receivers for Jim Donnan's offense.
Third down. And about 1.5 yards for the Bulldogs to keep this drive going. Tennessee shows blitz. They stay at home. It was an option. It was an option in the back. Either the quarterback or the tailback went the wrong way.
Yeah, Jasper Sanks goes to the left. Quincy Carter goes to the right. And it's very fortunate for Georgia he didn't catch that ball, because it would have been out there to a ghost. But a nice stand by Tennessee. Quincy Carter moving out to the right. And they would have had the first down, Ron, if Jasper Sanks was supposed to go to the right. Nobody on the